Howdy everyone, y'all know it's me, Voltage, and I think I've kept this thing going for far long enough. I've had this thing finished for about a week now, and I'm gonna finish this story and actually post on my channel, finish it. This is my second story, part two. I'm gonna be trying to finish it today, so let's go. Wahoo! Flashes to Sniff getting tortured. Sniff screams in pain as she gets hit by a flamethrower from Phalanx. You will tell me what I want to know, or I will kill you. Phalanx says. Sniff says, No matter what, I won't break. You can torture me or kill me, but I won't give you info about my friend's true weaknesses. Phalanx, I can arrange your funeral if that's what you want. You just hyper beam on Sniff and slams an iron tail across her head, slamming her against the bars of the cage. Sniff gasps in pain, falling to the floor. I won't fall, guys. Please hurry. Takes an iron tail of the skull, leaving a bump in her head as she blacks out. Phalanx, I'm getting nowhere with these two. I'm going to give your friends a day if to show up. If they don't, these two die. Flashes back to Mayhem. Ryo, I can sense any evil aura and pain. We should head towards the dungeon, seeing as we've all recovered, Vortex says. Eve says, let's move. 3 hours later, outside the dank forest, Mayhem starts shaking uncontrollably. Zappy turns to Mayhem. Are you alright? Mayhem says, no, this is where I died and where I'm buried. Zappy says, alright, but wait, aren't you here only to stop Phalanx? Only, what happens when we win? Mayhem says, best not to ask right now. Flashes to Voltage, beaten and bloodied inside a cage, barely alive. Voltage thinks, this is the thought right here. I've taken a lot of punishment. Why am I still here? Should I return home to my world? I mean, I want to stay here, but if I die, I don't know what's gonna happen. If I die here, I'm not sure what happens. Voltage is human, like I said in the first story, so if he dies in the Pokemon world, he's not sure what will happen, because like that's actually a good mystery for him to solve. I'm not dying here, I have to escape and find Sniv. Voltage struggles to his feet, using all his strength as left to use an iron tail on the bar of his cage. The bar shatters, giving room for Voltage to escape. Flashes back to the others on the fourth floor with no Pokemon having appeared. Mayhem says he wants no interference. Vortex says it's us versus him only. Ryo says, let's keep going. Zappy falls silently with Eve. Mayhem finally, he's directly ahead of us, spots the stairs. Flashes back to a severely injured Voltage. Spots Sniv knocked down a cage, using iron tail on the bar. As it shatters, he feels his insides lurch as he falls to the ground. 2 minutes later, Sniv moans and gets up, seeing Voltage outside of her cell, unconscious with gashes all over his body, with his fur a bright red. Oh no, he's taking a ton of damage, and I don't have any Oberon berries. And I couldn't heal myself. I mean, I could heal myself, but he couldn't. I mean, because Sniv knows synthesis, which can heal herself. But Voltage knows no healing moves. So that's why Voltage has taken a lot more damage than Sniff has, because Sniff has managed to heal herself always. Then Sniff picks Voltage up with her vines and carrying him. I need to get medical help from him now. Sniff limps away. Flashes back to the others on the fifth floor, arriving on the fifth floor. Phalanx, so you made it in on time. Your Voltage is almost dead. Mayhem screams in rage, using Iron Tail towards Phalanx. Chill out, Chaos. He's not dead yet like you are. Phalanx uses Psychic, slamming Mayhem against tree after tree, then slams her into the ground, knocking her out. Ryo says, May, oh no, let's move, guys. It's 4-on-1. Charges towards Phalanx. Phalanx uses Iron Tail on Ryo, who uses Counter, slamming into Phalanx's gut, causing him to double over. Phalanx has already seen enough, uses Hyper Beam on Ryo, then follows with a Flamethrower. Flamethrower is super effective on Ryo. Ryo loses. Ryo takes both hits, starting to glow a bright white in the flamethrower. Ryo the Lucario, he evolved right here. Okay, now it's time for some fun. Charges Phalanx using Drain Punch. Phalanx gets hit flying into a tree. Gets up, eyes glowing a brighter lime. I'm ending this now, fires 5 Hyper Beams. Then using Psychic, slamming Vortex, Eve, Zap, and Ryo into each other. Into the path of the Hyper Beams. Vortex flies into the air, hitting the ground unconscious. Zap flies into a rock, hitting his head, leaving a dent in his head, knocking him out. Eve flies into a tree, falling to the ground unconscious. Falling to the ground, knocked out. Ryo flies toward a tree, into the air toward the tree, but he bounces off with his feet, and then he launches towards Phalanx with the aura spear in his palm and slams it into his face. Chaos fades out of Mayhem's body, ready to continue the fight. Phalanx screams in pain as it takes an aura spear to the face. Enough uses a psychic, slamming Ryo into the rear towards the ground. Sniff leaps behind Phalanx with Iron Tail, using Iron Tail with Volt still in his mind. Phalanx shouts in pain, "I've seen enough." He releases Ryo and grips Voltage with Psychic, yanking him out of Sniff's grasp. "Checkmate. If you move 1 foot, Voltage dies." Voltage opens his eyes as his vision focuses on his friends all knocked out besides Sniff. His eyes glow orange as he uses Surf towards Phalanx. "Sniff, Lucario, heal the others. Please, my fight is done. I've taken so much damage." Phalanx sees the Surf slamming into him, then unleashes an Iron Tail on Voltage and then a Hyper Beam. Voltage goes flying in the air, screaming in pain, before he hits the ground. His eyes turn gold as he feels a wave of rage coming from him. If his eyes turn gold, his Master Berserk has reached his limit. Because it only happens when he's in near-death experience. And after taking those 2 hits, he's really close to death. But this instantly heals all his battle wounds and makes him much, much, much faster, much, much, much stronger. Lands on all fours, vanishing from sight. He appears behind Phalanx using an Iron Tail, sending him into the air as Sniff heals the others. Voltage leaps up using a Volt Tackle, midair slamming onto Phalanx, then using Surf, summoning a massive Surf, and slams it into a midair using a massive Thunderbolt. This sends Phalanx flying towards the ground as Voltage flashes out of sight, appearing behind Phalanx using an Iron Tail, sending him towards Chaos. Mayhem, Vortex, Ryo, Eve, Zap, and Sniff all charge, won't move, sending 4 Iron Tails. From Mayhem, Zap, Ryo, and Sniv, they all know Iron Tail, so they use it. And Eve uses Bite while Vortex uses a Hydro Pump after the others. All moves hit Phalanx as he flies towards Voltage and Chaos, who's floating next to him. Chaos nods at Voltage as they both use Iron Tail, slamming Phalanx face first into the ground with energy all over his body, knocking him out. Phalanx gasps in pain as the virus leaves his body. "Now this is the virus talking. So you've taken my horse up permanently. He's too weak for my needs. But you, little Pikachu, you're perfect." Voltage screams in rage, charging the virus, firing off tons of thunderbolts. Virus looks unfazed. "You can't hurt me." Voltage's eyes glow even brighter gold. "I'm not giving up ever." Builds all his energy into a massive blast as he charges forward using Catastropica. That's a Z move. If you guys didn't know, he slams into the virus before busting out the other side. The virus bursts apart into a golden light, exploding into a charge of light. Chaos gasps, "It's finally done." Looks down, seeing lights fading off her body. "Everyone, I didn't want to tell you that, but with us stopping the virus, my purpose for being here is gone. Thank you for being our friend." Looks at Chaos and says, "I knew this was coming when I saw you. I knew you were here for revenge." Chaos looks into Voltage's blue eyes as she starts to draw towards the beam. "I'm happy you're safe, but everyone, I will not come back. I can finally rest in peace." Chaos fades into Mayhem's body as it gets surrounded by yellow light and moves into the sky. Ryo waves goodbye. Sniff, Vortex, Eve, and Voltage all wave goodbye as the light fades away. Voltage picks up Phalanx. "Let's go back to the Guild." Guild of Tales Infirmary. Voltage arrives, dropping Phalanx on a bed. Ryo, Vortex, Sniff, Eve, and Zappy follow behind him. Voltage starts to glow rainbow light. "Guys, I think my time has come." Sniff looks at Voltage with tears in his eyes. "Voltage, why have to go?" "I'm sorry, Sniff. I've been here for 7 years. It's my time to return home." His eyes start to tear up as he looks towards Eve and Vortex. "Eve, Vortex, thank you for giving me a chance to join the team. I had lots of fun with you." Eve looks at Voltage, who is slowly glowing brighter. "Voltage, thank you for sticking with us always and being our friend. I appreciate you always being there for us. No matter what, I won't forget you." Vortex looks sadly at Voltage. You've always been tough in their fights, Voltage. Please, at the very least, when you're gone, remember us, the ones who gave you a chance. We will always be here. I assume you got sent here for the purpose of saving Phalanx. Voltage turns back to Sniv, Zap, and Ryo. "Thank you for putting everything on the line to save me and Sniv. I wish I could know you both better." Voltage starts to feel his mind slipping away. As rainbow light starts to lift him into the sky, he manages to say one last thing. "No matter how far apart, I will always consider you my friend. Thank you for having adventures with me. One way or another, we will meet again." The end? Not completely. An epilogue I made. These are all thoughts with the exclamation marks on them. 5 years later, Volt, Sniff looks around, seeing FedEx, Rio, and Zap. Now this is a thought part here. It's been 5 years since I've lost Voltage, who I consider one of my few friends. I've moved on a lot of FedEx, Rio, and Zap to join my team. Team Zap, leave mine and Voltage's team. Even Vortex have both stayed at the Guild on their own teams. Every now and again, I feel sad knowing my friend is gone from my side, as well as Chaos finally being able to rest in peace. But in the end, I'm determined not to keep going for my friends and for Voltage and Chaos. No matter what, I won't lose. Thank you for sticking with me, Voltage, and everyone, but our paths will collide again. Now it's time for Phalanx. Phalanx, it's been 12 years since I got inflicted with the virus. 5 years ago, I got saved by Sniv, Voltage, Rio, Zap, Eve, Vortex, and Chaos. And after I had woken up from in the hospital of the Guild, I found out Chaos was finally resting in peace, while Voltage got sent back home. The only two friends I'd known at that point, besides Sniv, who I had met in the Superior Guild, which I destroyed against my own will, are now gone from this world. I want both, but no matter what, I will enjoy my life and make up for wrongdoings. This is Phalanx saying farewell. Vortex. I am in the Guild with Eve. We have stayed together as a team, and I have gotten much stronger. I think I could even rival Voltage. Right. Voltage, he went back home to the human world. I wonder if he remembers us. Either way, Sniff, Zappy, Rio, Phalanx went their separate ways. They joined Sniff's team. I will stay strong, my friends. We will meet again. Eve looks wistfully at Vortex, knowing what he is thinking. I know Voltage is on our minds, even 5 years after him leaving and Chaos resting. We must move on, no matter what. I keep us going, me and Vortex. Vortex was closer to Voltage than I was. I made a promise to him before he left to keep going, and I will. Thank you for the adventures, Voltage. Now, it flashes to Voltage. Voltage, this is the thought process. I still think about my friends who were always there for me, through thick and thin. Vortex and Eve both gave me a chance to join their team. I've had fun with them. I always kid about their teammates. Sniff, I've known him for many years. He's been my friend for 6 of my 7 years in the Pokemon world. He stayed by my side, even visited me when I was stuck on the run. Chaos, who I've known ever since I became a Pikachu, I see her in my dreams all the time. She was chaotic, but always adamant to protect her friends. She gave her life protecting those she cared about. Last but not least, Phalanx, my first Pokemon I knew when I joined the world. I woke up seeing an Umbreon standing over me. I was startled, but he calmed me down. Then one day, he just left with no warning. I found out he had been possessed by a virus. It took 7 years to free him, but it was costly. I was forced to go back to the human world. I have not been able to return for 5 years. I will stay where I'm needed. I hope I can go back to the world with my friends eventually. Voltage, a rainbow light starts to go around him. And that's the end of my story too. I spent about 15 hours working on this thing and making it done. But who said just because the second story is done, it's over with? No. I never let stories end like that. Part 3 will be coming out in the next few days. Voltage, Return of the Legend, Forgotten Memories. He came back, but I'm not going to spoil anything right now because I want this thing to be cool, you guys who are reading this from YouTube itself. So thank you so much for sticking with me for my first two story parts. But this ends off with Chaos. Well, Mayhem's done the stories now. Mayhem's just done. We won't see Mayhem ever again in the stories. Chaos? Who says Chaos is completely done? Plus, who says Voltage is done? Because you saw the rainbow light coming up around him. That's what brought him into the world in the first place. It was actually Chaos that brought him in. You know, guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to leave a like, subscribe if you're new. See you next time. I had fun.